Any station that at this district?
Three. There's a station here.
Panda.
Yes.
There's another panda here. Where is your vehicle? This vehicle. Where is up in that? Is it easy? No, you are not picking this. Who are you meeting? And is there a chief there or something? Is there here? Is there? You have chief there. So from here, going to the Paramount Chief. You will not be able to see the DC if you want to meet us at the Paramount Chief. How many years have you guys been here? Where were you before you came?
I went to the depot.
Who depot?
Who depot?
Where from your wife?
Yeah, I'm married from here.
From here?
It's from Boy.
Then you are not going to
the station. I find myself. Well, I need a change, but your mother to understand that here is the punishable time.
No, never, never,
so
never.
You tried. That was the first question.
Why do you carry something that can never be a punishment ground? Wherever there is a police station, we need to get people to go and work there. And when you are sent to work there, you just make the best out of it. You never know what happens in somebody. Don't ever let anybody determine or define something for you to carry along. If you do that, you become just a messenger. It means you don't have a brain of your own. People think for you, and that's it. Your first station, you have been put here from. So you were recruited, and as soon as you grew, somebody decided to punish you. That's important. I don't know whether any IGP has come to you here before. Has an IGP been here?
Has
an IGP been in this town? We don't see any place at the bank. And look at this hour that we have been here.
information.
That the whole IGP and commissioners will just be working day and night. Don't. Just for the sake of protecting life and property and serving humanity. And if you serve humanity, somebody says it's punishment. So death is also punishment. Because when you come, you see people who are dead and buried. Are they punished? God wants to take you. Nobody can stop it. But the person is not God. But wherever you find yourself, may the face of you at a good time. God destiny will shine. I'm ready to work in anybody. Because my passion is to serve. Passion is not to, as I've always been saying, walk with my stomach. And if you walk with your stomach, you try to believe some of these things and you're consumed by it. But if you walk with your conscience, you see that oriented, fear God, and is so humane and patriotic. When your conscience already, swing a man. Now what man ni patima? Now what do? Emma wo mine ni a wuye. Did you be as one yen? I don't know yet. Yesterday slept around almost 3 and got up by 7 o'clock. We have been on it up to this time. And we are not even halfway what we are wanting to do today. Because Makando, from there, we are going to Banda. From Banda, we are going to Masa. From Masa, we are going to KJB. From KJB, we will end up with Kakamigasa. So imagine. It's almost 7 o'clock now. 6 days, 7. We are not defined by time. We are defined by our conscience and the passion that carry us through. And that is the message you came to give.
I just want to say something because of what you said. IG has spoken a lot about this. But I just want to add that if you hadn't been to Chinderi, you would have still been a fighter by now. True or false?
Or am I the wrong person? We'll be beating you by now.
That's the point. And you have two beautiful children.
And you are in situ.
Yes.
With a mini tie.
You see, whatever goes down, what I've just said is the problem that you have taken the right flower or you have found the wrong wife. You would have followed me.
You'll be dead by now.
Yes. Let me give just a short story. The year was 2000. And our divisional commander, Akuffo, at the time, Akuffo division included
Akuffo police.
At that time, Don Kupro was there, so it was a district under Kupro. Chiasi was the station under Don Kupro. And so, I was the register for one. I had one station called Asmoni Ways Police Station. How many of you know Asmoni Ways? It's under Kupro. In those days, when the railways was booming, as Bonny Rails police, or as Bonny Rails, that's why they call it as Bonny Rails, and Bowu West municipality was a booming business center. It was one of the major stops for all the trades, the sleepers.
That was from Accra to Kumasi, Kumasi to Accra. So it was, the town was booming. And so the police station there was hotcake. Every police man wanted to work there. By 2007, when I was the divisional commander and I took over, when I taught my entire division, I found out that Asubani Rails was a ghost of its old glory. It was a ghost town. Literally everything had ground to a halt.
The cost of the country, the railways, is gone into coma. And so, similarly, because the town itself had gone that way, the police station itself deteriorated to the point that here, comparatively, it's less than national headquarters. Look at the beautiful police station. As Bonny Rails Police Station in 2007, the state in which it was more like, I don't have a word to describe it. And when I got there, they were rotating personnel at Bonny Rails Police Station. There was no single person there. And so it was 3 months rotational basis, drawn from throughout the division. So it means that when you went there, if anybody who was rotated, you go there. When you finish and you are sent back to your mother station, you will not go there until maybe after 2 years, because the numbers were huge in the division. So when I got there not long after, I did a rotation. I think it was my second rotation. And then one of the personnel, like you, thought that we're punishing him. So 3 days after he was sent to Asubani Rails for 3 months rotation, I was in my office where my regional commander, Eastern Region, at that time, BCOP retired, Asaridapo. How many of you know me? You are all small boys, so you don't know me. He's retired now. He called, and I picked. I said, yes, sir. Is that Winnie? I said, yes, sir. He said, one of your children is in front of me now, and that you sent him to a punishment ground, but he doesn't know what he has done. And I said, Master, who is that, sir? And he mentioned him. And then he told me that, oh, this boy, I know him, he's an operational guy. So I want you to send him back to his station. He was taken from Kuru traffic. I want you to send him back to his station, because he's an operational guy. He can help you to fight armed robbery in a cohort district. And I say, yes, sir. Because when your boss tells you this and gives you the order, what can you say? I say, yes, sir. Let him come back. By the time he comes, he just pack his things and go to his mother's place. Because he had given me the marching orders. Then immediately I put the phone down, I called my district commander from cohort, and also gave him directives. I said, reverse this rotation. Get somebody else there. But before he came, a special runner had put the signal at his body room and a copy to his mother's place that he came back. That same week, Saturday, I got up in the morning trying to organize and go to the office and see whether I could clear some few things. So I was just preparing one of my phone calls and I picked it. It was one of my friends from Obuaba FM. Coco. Amanda, I say, yes, my brother, how are you? He said, fine, but not fine. I said, why? He said, I'm not fine because one of your men has been butchered to death. I said, my brother, why Saturday morning, why are you joking in this manner with me? What do you mean? How can you say one of my men has been butchered? He said, Commander, I'm serious about this. How can I joke with such a thing? Your man has been butchered to death, and his AK-47 weapon has been taken from him. Yeah. I said, wow. Then I'm not asking where. Go, go, go.
form a crime officer, mobilized some men, and we were stayed. When I got there, sorry, it was a very sorry sight. There was like a ball of meat without any shape. Black all over the place. And the brief facts I had were very horrified. A certain drug addict from a neighboring village had slashed a small boy with a cutlass. And then the villagers mobilized and wanted to lynch him. So he ran all the way to go across the police station. That Saturday morning when he got there, there was no police officer around. So he ran to the first floor of the Kofrasu police station. It is like a residence. It houses about three personnel people, but the station is out. So when he went up there, then he now stood by the steps with the cutlass, still with the blood dripping, daring any of the crowd to come. And so they surrounded the building, and the first man to go couldn't do it. So the police, one of the police wives called the station officer, he was nowhere near him. They called around, they couldn't get any of the personnel except this guy. He was on guard duty at the funny truck station depot in the Akuffo. The time they were doing the road, it was funny truck that were doing it. So they called him that this is the situation, could he come to help? So he got up from his duty post with his motorbike and his AK loaded with 30 rounds. Got to the place, packed his motorbike. And as he was climbing, the guy retreated with the weapon, of course, with the cutlass. Retreated. So he got up there and told the guy that, hey, you see these guys, let me take you down, put you in the cells, because if I don't do that, they'll kill you. Then he told the guy, our officer, that you see, sir, if you take me now and I'll follow you down, they will wrestle you, take me from you and still kill you. So, sir, and you don't go down and disperse them, and then come and look at you. The mistake our officer made was that, instead of disarming him first, he didn't do that. He turned. He really did what the guy said. That was a mistake. From eyewitnesses, he came for the neck. Cutlass was sharp. We almost took off the head. Then he fell on the steps and started rolling down. And he was, and the body in the death throes. He did that. So he got down there. And then took the AK, cocked and fired. He was a militia in the PNDC days. 30 rounds. So he was the champion in town. And then he now got into the police. When I got there and finally identified them for this guy, then I asked myself, well, okay, if this guy was at the Suboni Range at the time they called him, would he have been here? The answer is no. God, in his divine wisdom, out of love for him, took him away. And he, with his human frailties, his inability to see into the next second, much more to say the next minute or even tomorrow, decided to scheme and dribble God back to the place. And you see what happened to him? So, my dear colleague, do you know where you would have been if you were not in Chinderi from the time you completed until now? Do you know where you would have been?
And I know, let's go to see the command. If you like to rest, at your, you have your back.
Okay. Coach in the ring, go to the punishment ground.
Thank you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.